in order to discuss the spread of the excitation or the spread of the action potentials through the heart, you need to remember that there are two cell types in the heart. There are the pacemaker cells, which are responsible for setting the heart rate, and there are the cardiac contractile cells, or the myocytes, that are responsible for the actual contraction of the heart. And so we are going to start at the SA node. And so located within the SA node are the pacemaker cells. Keep in mind that pacemaker cells are located throughout the conduction system. However, we are going to begin with the SA node because that's how it happens in a normal healthy heart. The pacemaker cells in the SA node are going to be generating action potentials. Remember that these are called pacemaker potentials or pacemaker action potentials. And this all, it once again, starts in the SA node. So once the action potential is generated, it can spread through the atria. And so to spread throughout the atria, they have to take two different pathways. One pathway is called the interatrial pathway. And if you think of the name, inter means between. So this is the pathway that's between the atria. If we want the action potential to spread to the opposite side of the heart, in other words, to the left atrium, it has to use the intraatrial pathway. And so you can see here, they're indicating the spread of the action potential to the left atrium. Now, to continue the spread of the action potential throughout the right atrium, that is going to take a different pathway, and that action potential is going to travel via the internodal pathway. So again, think of the name. Inter is between, nodal, node, so we're between two nodes. And so the nodes that were between the SA node and the AV node. So once this action potential spreads through the atria, so the action potentials have spread through the atria to the AV node, and once they've spread to the AV node, conduction slows. This is called an AV nodal delay. At this point, if we're thinking about filling of the heart, the ventricles would be 80% filled with blood. And the reason we have the AV nodal delay is once these atria, or once the ventricles rather, are 80% filled, then the atria will contract. And when the atria contract, then the remaining 20% of blood will enter the ventricles. So it's like we're squeezing the atria to force that rest, that 20% down into the ventricles. So notice here we had an electrical event occur first. We had action potential spreading from the SA node through the atria to the AV node. Once they got to the AV node, then the atria contract. That's an important concept. Electrical events occur before mechanical events. So now from the AV node, the action potentials are going to continue to spread. So from the AV node, they spread down the bundle of His, and then they spread down through the right and left bundle branches, and then they reach the apex of the heart. It's the tip, not the top of the heart, but the tip, the bottom of the heart. So once the action potentials reach the apex of the heart, then the action potentials are going to spread to the Purkinje fibers. You can see how once that action potential reached the apex, the action potential spread via the Purkinje fibers up the walls of the ventricles. So now we have an action potential that spread through the ventricles. Once this has happened, now, so you've had your electrical event occur within the ventricles will contract. And when the ventricles contract, where is the blood going? Think about which valves the blood has to pass through and where that blood is going. Now we have a state where the heart is now resting. It's resting and it's waiting for the pacemaker to spontaneously depole and to start this whole process over again. Remember, pacemaker cells are only at rest momentarily, so there's not a lot of time here for pacemaker cells to even get any kind of rest at all. So here's the concept. Action potential spread through the atria, so that's your electrical event. Then they contract. Then the action potential spreads through the ventricles, so that's your electrical event. Then the ventricles contract. Notice there's a rhythm here. So electrical event through the atria, then the atria contract. Electrical event through the ventricles, then the ventricles will contract.